And a good Sunday, everybody. Jewel here with you with J7409 weather. Today is the 30th of August, 2020. Thank you so much for checking out the weather with me today. My internet is running very, very slowly. I will try to have a tropical update later this evening, just a tropical update. But right now, we're going to start off what's going on in the tropics with the general weather forecast. Yes, it looks like things are popping. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4 systems to watch right now. We'll start out with disturbance number 1. These thunderstorms and showers is still just a tropical wave. They're gradually moving westward away from the Lesser Antilles. Now, the disturbance remains disorganized at this time. Now, some gradual development of the system is possible during the next several days while it moves westward around 15 to 20 miles per hour across the Caribbean Sea. Regardless of development, this system will continue to produce gusty winds and locally heavy rainfall across portions of the Windward and Leeward Islands this morning before it diminishes this afternoon. Now, in 2 days, it's 20. 5 days, it's 30. I do believe from the last time, I can't check everything this morning. Like I've said, my internet's running too slow for some of it to load. I do believe it's going to come up this way, though. Possibly come up this way, bounce off, come back up, come up this way, and then track this way. As of the last time I got to check, that's what it was looking like. Now, disturbance number 2. This is a tropical wave. It's moving westward. It's over the eastern Atlantic, several hundred miles southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands. Now, this system is producing limited shower activity, and any further development is expected to be slow to occur while it moves slowly westward over the eastern and central tropical Atlantic. It's got zero chance of doing anything in 2 days, 30% in 5 days. We will keep our eyes on all of these systems. Brand new one popped up today. Well, we've got 2 actually, but disturbance number 3. I know all of my friends in Florida are probably bugging out right now, but don't. It's an area of low pressure. Now, it's going to form off the southeastern coast of the United States in a day or two. Now, this is going to come off the coast of Florida. Before I read any more of this, it's like right here in the Gulf right now, we have a high pressure. Now, this is going to push all this tropical moisture moving on along, and it's going to go out. But this is going to develop. Now, development of this system is possible, and a tropical depression is likely to form by the middle of the week while the system moves northeastward or east-northeastward, initially parallel to the southeastern coast of the U.S. and away from land. 2 days, 50%. 5 days, 70%. I did manage to look up one little thing about this system. Looks like when it gets right off my coast, it may stall a little bit, but hopefully it will stay off the coast. May bring us some rain, maybe some breezy, gusty conditions, but nothing like a high-end tropical storm or a hurricane at this time. We've got to watch it and make sure it does go out to sea and up and off and doesn't endanger anyone. Now, we have disturbance number 4. It's a new tropical wave. It's expected to emerge off the coast of Africa in a couple of days. Some gradual development of this system will be possible through the end of the week while it moves slowly westward over the eastern tropical Atlantic. Couple of days, 0, 5 days, 20. I think it will form, and I do think this one will form also. Wherever they go, we'll have to track, we'll have to watch all of these systems, each and every one of them, all 4. Severe weather today. Well, there is a slight risk of some severe thunderstorms over parts of the North Central Plains this afternoon and evening through the nighttime hours. Now, severe hail and gusts may occur from these thunderstorms over parts of the North Central Plains this afternoon and evening. So please be aware of that, especially if you're up in, the areas of South Dakota, western, southwestern Minnesota, little bit of Iowa here in the northwestern corner, moving down into Nebraska. Marginal chance, Texas Panhandle all the way across to parts of northwestern Georgia, parts of Tennessee, Mississippi, Arkansas, northern Louisiana, parts of Oklahoma here. You see in this darker green, some severe thunderstorms could pop up. Hopefully no tornadoes will occur today. The greatest chance is only 2%, and hopefully none will make up, and that goes from North and South Dakota down into Nebraska, where the possibility may occur, but it is slight at 2%. Now, when we look at the wind, wind is going to blow. You folks in South Dakota, the section of Minnesota, Iowa, down into Nebraska, you do have a 15% chance of feeling some very brisk winds going on, so please pay attention to that. And the hail is in the very same area at 15%. However, wherever you see the brown, no matter where it's at, there is that slight chance. If you do have a thunderstorm pop up and it does become severe, you could have some possibility of hail mixing in with it. As we take a look at the current watches and warnings forecast map here, you can see everything that's going on. We got heavy rain and flash flooding that's possible across the Tennessee and Mississippi valleys, with additional heavy rains across the Mid-Atlantic. That's going to start tomorrow. Now, main headlines for today is the heat down in Louisiana and Texas. You guys got probably another day of triple-digit high temperatures coming your way. Looking like maybe by tomorrow, Monday, you might have a slight cool-up, maybe 98 degrees. But as for today, it's looking like triple digits, so be aware of that. We got a flood watch going on here in southeast Arizona, central Arizona, all of these areas here. We'll get to more of that in a moment. And the red flag warnings are out from Idaho, down into Utah, up into Wyoming, all the way across to central Nebraska, and down in the Colorado area here. Please be aware of this. These fires are very dangerous. They're easy to start. Most of them this year has started with cloud-to-ground lightning, but a couple of them were set on fire on purpose from everything that I've understood and read and researched. So keep this in mind. Be safe in these areas. Please do not burn outside in these areas today. This is the NAM map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. This will take us through the next 3 days. You can see the timestamp right here, August 30th, 2020. If you haven't subscribed and you are into the weather, please do so. I'd like to thank all of my regular subscribers, and a big thank you to all of my new subscribers. Please click subscribe, click the bell, and make sure that you check off all, because if you don't do that, you know how YouTube is. You will not get my notifications when I put out a new video. I thank you very much and appreciate your support. Now, this map will show, you can see right here, there's still nothing but rain. That's all it is here in Florida, but you see this, and in the next 3 days, you're going to see it form and try to come up this way. So don't be alarmed. This is what you're going to see. As we turn it on here, and check out all of the weather. It looks like we got a stall frontal boundary draped from the Tennessee Valley back into the middle Mississippi Valley. And that should continue to provide a focus for showers and thunderstorms the next couple of days in these areas. Now, heavy rain is possible, which would elevate the flash flood threat. Now, especially considering much of the region's already saturated after former tropical cyclone Laura moved through last week. Now, a surface low riding along the boundaries forecast to lift towards the mid-Atlantic states by Monday, tomorrow, with another round of moderate to heavy rainfall and the possibility of flash flooding across portions of the interior mid-Atlantic and the central Appalachians. By Tuesday, a second cold front approaching from the west will increase chances for heavy rainfall and severe weather again across parts of the South Central Plains. Now, we have a strong cold front. Yes, how about that? I'm talking about a cold front and coolness. A strong cold front pushing eastward across the northern plains today, and it will bring with it a chance for heavy rainfall and the severe weather with showers and storms that I just showed you pushing up into the area and by Monday in the upper Midwest. So keep that in mind if you're out and about and you're in these areas. Now, daytime highs in these areas, 10 to 20 degrees below normal. Meanwhile, across the southern high plains, triple digit heat. It's going to continue today, as I've just showed you where. Now, meanwhile, we got to check out the monsoonal moisture streaming into the southwestern states. Now, this could cause locally heavy rainfall and possibly flash flooding the next few days. To the north, dry and windy conditions will contribute to elevated to critical fire weather threats across portions of the Great Basin and into the Central Rockies, especially by Monday following the cold frontal passage. Those red flag warnings are widespread throughout this region, as I showed you, and you know where you could have some flash flooding to occur is down in this monsoonal portion of Arizona, right in this area here, if it does occur. And you can see the rain is going to creep up slowly but surely as the days go by. So keep all this in mind. And there's the system right there. Let's see if we can run it up a little bit right quick. Here we go. You see it right here. Looking like maybe a tropical storm. I think it has a good chance of forming into a tropical storm. Let's just pray it stays away from land for everybody. And everybody stays safe. But don't worry, I'll keep my eyes on the tropics and all four of these developments as they happen. Just as soon as my internet gets a little bit stronger, I'll have a tropical update for you later this afternoon or early evening. Have a good day, a safe day, a blessed day. Thank you guys for everything you do for me. I love you so very much, and I appreciate it with all my heart. Much peace, love, and kindness to each and every one of you, and thank you for watching.